So here we are at Apex, where you can find so many different types of products to put on your car, in your car, around your car, but more importantly, to fix your car in some cases. David, you've got a product called Cubon that does some amazing things. Tell me about it.
Well, Cubon here is an adhesive that you could either use by itself or with the powders, depending on what you're trying to repair. Okay. The glue is really original because it dries flexible, mm-hmm. So it can be used on various materials, whether it be O-rings, gaskets, seals, belts. It's resistant to chemicals, so it won't break down if it comes in contact with gasoline, mm-hmm. Oil, coolant, heat, or pressure. You know, it has high thresholds as well, 356 degrees mm-hmm. and up to 1300 PSI.
So this is for something that you want to bond together, or two pieces that you want to connect and stay connected.
That's correct, absolutely. If you have something that may have snapped, maybe clips on door panels mm-hmm. or tabs on headlights, or if you have something that has grown weak that you see that is starting to crack and you want to stop, you could reinforce it with the powders if you have holes or cracks.
Mm-hmm. And I see in your hand here you have a round belt, which could be a power belt for all sorts of things, where there's a vacuum cleaner or a component on a car, a boat, or something. And I noticed that it bonds it very, very quickly
yep.
and very strongly.
Absolutely. So what we have here is this is just a generic piece of rubber, whether it be, like you said, any kind of belts or whatnot. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to just demonstrate how quick it sets up. I'm taking just the Cubon adhesive here, and I'm going to take my broken material. I'm going to place just one teardrop on one side of the broken surface. Now, glue doesn't like to stick to glue, so you just glue one side of your broken material. Mm-hmm. You do your best to line it back up mm-hmm. and then place it back together. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. It takes 10 seconds for it to cure, as I said. Now, it's anaerobic, meaning the lack of oxygen is what cures it. So you don't work it. You just put it together, and you push and hold. Mm-hmm. After 10 seconds, you really don't need to wait much longer. It'll be a full curity. You could wipe off the excess, which is what I'm going to do here. Mm-hmm. And then pretty much what I'm trying to do here is show you that you could move it, bend it, twist it, and pull it, and it won't tear on you. So
very, very simple to use, very effective. And from the standpoint of being able to repair something as simple as this, that can be quite a tool in an emergency or a space that you're broken down and you need to get back on the road again.
That's exactly right. You know, I carry this everywhere I go. I'm in the extreme sports and whatnot, paddling. So I carry it with my motorcycle. You know, I carry it in my suitcase. Yeah. I carry it in my car. I have one pretty much in every room of my house. So it's just the uses are just endless.
Now, it goes much further than that. You've got the ability to bond plastics and even form literally your own metal.
Precisely. If you have a bolt that's stripped, a mount or a bracket snapped, mm-hmm. you could not only refill it and re-drill and tap it, because this does not crack up when you drill and tap it, uh-huh. but you could recreate. If you could create a form with some putty, uh-huh. you could actually create your own clips and tabs.
If so you kind of make your own mold and then pour this into it.
100%.
Show me how that works.
So we have two powders here. We have a gray powder, uh-huh. which is primarily used for fixing metals. It's based out of aluminum.
Okay.
And then we have a black powder, which is a carbon graphite base. It's made for fixing plastics.
Got it.
And other materials. Now, what you do with this is you simply just pour it on a surface you're trying to repair. I'm going to go ahead and pour just a small pile here mm-hmm. onto my board. You can move it, shape it, mold it. The powder's non-toxic. You could even sink a stud into it if you need to. Mm-hmm. But when you do that and you're ready, you take the same Cubon adhesive I used before. You just pour, you just saturate it. There's no specific ratio, so you just pour the adhesive onto the pile.
So you can't mess up by putting too much or too little?
Absolutely not, no. Okay. After it's fully saturated, after it does not take anymore, you'll notice that it just starts rejecting the glue. So uh-huh. that's how you know when it's fully cured. Typically, you'll see a little bit of a chemical reaction. That's a curing, and then 10 seconds later, mm-hmm. literally 10 seconds, it gets all the harder it is. So straight away, you could, if you need to, you have the ability to grind it down, sand it to a fine finish, mm-hmm. paint it, mm-hmm. prime it, powder
drill
coat
through it, whatever you need.
Powder right. coat it, drill it, tap it. Yep, mm-hmm. absolutely.
Drill it, tap it. Wow, okay. Interesting. Wow. So that opens up a door to repair all sorts of items.
That's correct. Now, my last example I want to share with you guys is for filling holes, gaps, and cracks. Because a lot of people get holes in whether it be maybe an oil pan uh-huh. or a coolant line or pretty much anything. Uh-huh. What you want to do is if you have the ability to get behind it, you want to put something just to stop the powder from falling through that hole.
Okay.
And then you just want to fill it up. with the powder.
Just create a little foundation there and
exactly
fill away.
Right. So I'll just put some powder in there, drop or two glue, a little more powder, a little more glue. It's important you do it in stages if it's a deep hole, because the glue cures so quickly that it may not penetrate all the way through.
It's kind of like if you're laying concrete, you want to do it layered at a time.
Exactly right. So literally 10 seconds again, you're going to see here, what I'm trying to show you, I mean, it's dry, but I want to show you that it seals off air and liquid tight, and it's hard for you guys to see probably, but it seals off air and liquid tight back there. So again, if you had chemicals, coolant, battery acid, heat, pressure, and as I mentioned before, you know, it has high resistance, but it's ready to go back on the car straight away.
Wow, that could get you back on the road really quickly if you're in an emergency and you end up with something that's sprung a leak, whether it's a hole in a valve cover or what have you.
Well, we use a valve cover just as an example for metal, but I mean, like we said, oil pans, radiators, some, I have this headlight here, headlight tabs always, and when you get fender benders, they shear off.
Yeah.
And people really just use this in the body industry to repair headlight tabs. Straight away, you're back on your way.
So the same premise, the same method is you're using the liquid and the powder to bond together.
Exactly right. When you're, just a quick tip, when you're putting two pieces together, you obviously want to get it drying and as clean as possible.
Sure.
As with anything. But when you're gluing it back together, you glue one side, you glue the two pieces back, and then if you want to reinforce it with the powder, just grind out over top of where it was cracked, just a little bit, where so you have somewhere to put the powder and layer the powder in that grind. So what it does is it gives more surface area to grab onto, just like you're welding.
Got it. Wow, fantastic product. I mean, again, this is one of those things that should be in every toolbox, every emergency kit.
Absolutely.
I mean, there's so many different things. From a hobbyist standpoint, you could create your own plastic parts or metal parts to be able to shape them or drill them or, like you said, tap them.
100%.
So limitless capabilities with this.
Absolutely. Now with the packaging here, I just want to share one last thing with you. The packaging comes like this. Looks like a box with two 10 milliliters of super glue in there. They come sealed.
Okay.
And then one of each of the powders I shared with you. Retail cost is around $16.
Okay.
Now what you want to do is they come with pins. You notice that I wasn't in a rush to seal back up my bottle of glue.
Right.
That's because Cubond is such a high grade where it doesn't clog the tip right away. And we have it specially designed. You don't want to cut it open. The pins are included. You want to close it. You want to open it, first of all, but close it off and store it with this pin here.
Uh-huh. Got it.
And then that'll keep it good for up to 2 years.
Okay. Wow. Wow. So it's not going to spoil in your glove compartment between uses.
No. Now, obviously, you don't want to store it somewhere in direct sunlight or in high humidity.
Right.
And
got
sometimes
it.
Cars get like that. But even still, it should still stand for a very long time.
Fantastic product. David, thank
nice
you so
to meet
much.
You. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.